गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 9 फ्रॉम योर हिस्ट्री सेक्शन, एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ कंपनी रूल इन इंडिया. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी दैट व्हाट वर द इवेंट्स दैट लेड टू एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द कंपनी रूल इन आवर कंट्री, हाउ द ट्रेड ऑफ द कंपनी स्टार्टेड एंड हाउ यूरोपियंस गेन्ड कंट्रोल ओवर आवर कंट्री. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द चैप्टर. Vasco da Gama landed at Calicut in 1498 and marked the beginning of the European era in Indian history. So, in Indian history, when we say that European era has started in our country, in an Asian country, when Vasco da Gama landed at Calicut in 1498, from that time, European era started. By the 16th century, the Portuguese had established their colony in Goa. Portuguese means they are from Portugal. So, by the 16th century, they established their colony in Goa. Firstly, they came for trade, no other reason. In the next century, India became a popular destination for a large number of European traders, adventurers, and missionaries from England, Spain, France, Holland, etc. So, in the next century, India was a popular destination. Everyone wanted to come to India. And who wanted to come to India? Large number of European traders, those people who like adventures, and missionaries from England. Missionaries from England means those Christians who want to spread their religion in our country also. Those who want to propagate their religion in our country also. They were from England, Spain, France, Holland, etc. The age of imperialism in India began with the weakening and eventually the disintegration of the Mughal Empire. Now, what is the meaning of the age of imperialism? Imperialism, it means that a country wants to conquer its neighboring country or other countries to use their resources for their own good. That is imperialism. So, the age of imperialism in India, it started when Mughal Empire disintegrated. Mughal Empire came to an end. Then, the age of imperialism started in India. The lack of a strong central authority led to the emergence of many independent states and that revolted against the weak successors of Aurangzeb. We all know that the successors of Aurangzeb were not so capable to hold the whole country, to hold the large empire. So, many small independent states emerged. And they fought against the weak successor of Aurangzeb. They were the states of Bengal, Awadh, Hyderabad and Mysore. The Sikhs, the Marathas, the Jats and the Rajputs also set up their own kingdoms. You know, we did not have unity at that time. India was divided into pieces, you can see. Hence, the stage was set up for Europeans to take advantage of this situation. So, we all know that union is strength, but we were not united. That's why it became easier for the Europeans to take advantage of the situation. Trading companies. Many European trading companies established their trading center in coastal areas of India. So many European trading companies were there, those who wanted to do trade with our country. They set up their centers at the coastal areas because from coastal areas it is easy to do trade because of the sea routes. The trading centers were called factories, the places where factors or officials worked. So these factories were different from nowadays factories. They are known as trading centers were known as factories where factors or officials people were worked. Some of the factories were fortified as a safeguard from the rival trading companies. You know, some of these factories were fortified. What is the meaning of fortified? They made forts so that the other trading company could not be able to attack them. They bought spices, cotton textile, indigo, एंड सॉल्ट पिट्स रॉ मटेरियल फॉर मेकिंग गन पाउडर एट चीप रेट्स फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड सोल्ड देम इन यूरोप एंड अमेरिका इन हाई प्राइस. सो व्हाट दे डिड, why they were so keen to do trade in our country, because from India they used to buy the things at very cheap prices and they used to sell in England and US in a very high prices. The huge profit margin led to a competition among the foreign trading companies. Eventually the other trading companies had to bow out to the English and French companies, who remained the main rivals in India. Afterwards, earlier so many companies were there, but afterwards only British and French companies were there, and these two companies were main rivals in India, main competitors in India. The East India Company. The history of the world has not witnessed a more amazing story than that of establishment of the British Empire in India. You know, the establishment of British Empire in India, it is a very amazing story, very, you know, hard to believe that how is that possible that people came here for trade and they started ruling the country. It was the, you know, we can say stupidity of Indian rulers of that time. It was not the result of a deliberate effort, but a series of episodes that finally led to political dominance of India by the East India Company. You know, so many things happened, and afterwards East India Company got the political dominance in the country. Means politically also they started gaining power over our country. The East India Company set up trading posts in Surat and the three presidency settlements at Fort William in Bengal, Fort St. George in Madras and the Bombay Castle. So, East India Company ne kya kiya? They started trading in Surat and three presidency settlements. Three areas they chose for their settlements. So, under those settlements, these settlements were set up in Bengal. That was at Fort William in Bengal, and then in Madras, that was Fort St. George, and then the Bombay Castle. So what was their technique? Their technique was to establish friendly relations with the local princes to further their profits. The Indian rulers signed alliances to secure the help of the British military to settle their internal rivalries. So that was the stupidity of Indian rulers, that they signed alliances with British, that Britishers could help them with the military, and they will give in return to the Britishers, they will give money, they will give villages, these kind of things, taking advantage of the situation. So Britisher took the advantage of the situation and they introduced the policy of divide and rule. They made the princes fight with each other and they ruled over them. As a result, the Indian princes became mere puppet in the hands of the English. So British princes, they lost their power and they became the puppets in the hands of Britishers. You can see the picture of East India Company House, London. Do you know, the East India Company enjoyed a privileged position with the English government and was granted special rights like trade monopolies and tax exemptions, causing resentment among the competitors. How could a trading company become an imperial power? This is the main question. How can a company that was just a trading company? The real answer is that the East India Company became an imperial power to protect its trading interest from European traders. So what was the main purpose? The main purpose was East India Company just wanted to have a monopoly over the trade. They just want to do the trade and they want to take away all the rivalries companies. So the company came into The company came into conflict with the other foreign traders and hence built up its own military and administrative department. So that was the reason, because they were fighting with other foreign traders, so company made its own military and administrative department. So that was not a small company, that was a huge company that has its own military. So it became such a strong force that it took over the governance of Bengal, Madras and Bombay. So we can estimate its power that in a very short time it took the governance of Bengal, Madras and Bombay. Gradually the trading company transformed into an auxiliary government and military power that ended only in 1858. Earlier it became so powerful in India that it gained all the political and other powers, but in 1858 it ended. It ended, that doesn't mean that India was free. It ended means company rule ended and the Indian governance went to the hands of the British crown. So this is all for today. Revise the chapter thoroughly and in the next video we will start these wars, the first Carnatic wars. Thank you students, have a nice day.